स्ट्रिंग बफर क्लास। स्ट्रिंग बफर क्लास इज एक्चुअली ए पीयर क्लास ऑफ स्ट्रिंग क्लास। इन लास्ट वीडियो यू सीन दैट वी कैन क्रिएट ए स्ट्रिंग इन जावा यूजिंग टू क्लासेस, वन इज कॉल्ड एज स्ट्रिंग क्लास एंड अनदर वन इज कॉल्ड एज स्ट्रिंग बफर क्लास। व्हेनेवर यू क्रिएट ए स्ट्रिंग यूजिंग स्ट्रिंग क्लास, इट क्रिएट्स ए स्ट्रिंग्स ऑफ फिक्स्ड लेंथ। Once you create a string, you cannot alter the character in a string. You cannot add any other characters. You cannot append any new characters. The manipulation on string is not possible here. But sometimes you need some strings where you have to modify, where you have to add a new character, or where you have to insert new character, append new character, change some of the characters, that is replace you have to do, or you have to add some additional string within the string, that you have to do, and that is possible with the help of string buffer. The string buffer class create a string where we can do some modification in the string. String buffer class creates strings of flexible length that can be modified in terms of both length as well as content. We can insert characters, substrings in the middle of a string or append another string to the end. Now, whatever the methods provided by the string class is also available in the string buffer class. Apart from these methods, the string buffer class also contains some other methods which is used for manipulation. Now the first one is called as insert method. If I want to insert substring in the existing string, then we can use a insert. It will accept two parameters. First one is the n. N indicates the position where you have to insert this s2 string. Now insert the string s2 at the point n of the string s1. That means this substring is inserted at a position n inside the string s1. Now the next method is called as setCharAt. This setCharAt modifies nth character to x. Here it will accept again two parameters. The first one is called as the position where you have to change the character, and x indicates the character you have to change. The old character is replaced with the new character. Next one is called as append method, which will accept a single parameter, that is string. S2 is a substring, appends the string S2 to S1 at the end. It is just like adding a new string to the existing string. Set length. If I want to limit the string, if the string is very large, we have to limit the string, then we are using set length. Sets the length of the string to S1 to N. If the string length is 50, if I use the here n value 20, that indicates it will return only the string with the 20 characters. The remaining part will be truncated. Now this is given here. If n is less than s1 dot length, s1 is truncated. That means the value given should be less than the original length of the string, then the remaining characters are truncated. If the n value, whatever the parameter we passed here, if the n value is greater than the string length, in that case additional zeros are added at the end. S1 is appended with some zeros.